すみません、この近くに ATM はありますか？そこの交差点を右に曲がると左側にコンビニがあります。ATM はコンビニの中にありますよ。こんにちは、ジャパニーズアモのミサです。Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you how to ask for directions and how to give directions in Japanese.So I've already made a lesson on how to ask for directions, no more doko, so check it out, but this time we're going to practice mainly giving directions, so we learn how to say go straight and turn right and stuff like that. Okay, 始めましょう。 So first, do you know how to say straight? We say まっすぐ、まっすぐ。 So to go straight, we would sayまっすぐ行く、まっすぐ行く。 So you often hear まっすぐ行ってください、まっすぐ行ってください。 Please go straight. And next, do you know how to say right and left? So right, we say 右、右。 And left, we say 左、左。Me on the right side and he on the left side. 右、左。 And if you want to say right side, we say 右側、右側。 And left side, 左側、左側。 So you often hear something like something は右側に見えます。 You'll see something on the right side, orSomething は左側にあります。You also hear the word ある、あります。Something is there. Something is located there. And instead of 右側、左側, you'll often also hear 右手、左手. So 右手 literally means right hand. 左手 left hand. Okay? We also say右手に見えます。右手にあります。左手に見えます。左手にあります。And when you want to say to turn right, we say 右に曲がる。右に曲がる。So remember, to go straight, we say まっすぐ行く。No particle between まっすぐ and 行く. It's まっすぐ行く. But when you want to say to turn right, we say 右に曲がる. We use the particle に to show the direction. 右に曲がる. Or to turn left, how would you say that? 左に曲がる. 左に曲がる. Alright, now look at this map that I created.And listen to the direction and guess where we are going. So imagine that we are at the station, okay? 駅にいます。駅, station. 駅にいます。Okay? So first I'm going to speak at normal speed.
この道をまっすぐ行って、二つ目の角を左に曲がると右側にあります。
Right now, more slowly.
この道をまっすぐ行って、二つ目の角を左に曲がると右側にあります。この道をまっすぐ行って、二つ目の角を左に曲がると右側にあります。どこに行きますか?
Where are we going? So first, I said, この道を, right? So, 道 means straight. Misa is misa, miso is miso, 道 is street. okay? 道, street, この道, this street, この道をまっすぐ行って、So, まっすぐ, you recognize, right? まっすぐ, straight. And then, 行く is to go, but it's in the te form, 行って, right? Go and. So when you want to say verb and, you always put the verb in the te form, right? And be careful, we use the o particle for 道をまっすぐ行って. Okay, we would say 右に曲がる with the ni particle when turning, for example. But when you want to say go straight on this road, go straight down this road, この道をまっすぐ行って. So we know we are going straight. And then I said 二つ目の角を. So maybe some people got the wrong answer because of this part. 二つ目の角. So it's to do with counting. Oh, counting in Japanese is so hard. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is how we count from 1 to 5, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But when we want to say the first corner, the second corner, for example, we say 一つ目の角、二つ目の角。Okay? 角 is how we say corner. 角。So if you want to say the corner of the card, you can say 角の角。角の角。Anyway, when you want to count a corner, we say 一つ、二つ。So depending on the object you're counting, you say different things. So if you want to count one person, you say Hitori. If you're counting something like a glass of water, you'd say Ippai. Omizu Ippai, a glass of water. So I already have a lesson on the counters on Patreon, so check it out if you want. Anyway, we also have to add this ne after the counter. Hitotsu, futatsu, to mean the first, the second. So we add this kanji me, that means I, to make the word one. Ichi to the first. So for example, if you want to say the first person, we would say hitori me instead of just hitori, which means one person. Hitori me, futari me, the second person. So we did the same for the first corner, the second corner. We say hitotsu me no kado, futatsu me no kado. The third corner, we say mitsu me no kado. Anyway, 二つ目の角を、again the O particle, 二つ目の角を左に曲がると、so, 左、left, 左に曲がる、turn left, right? So, turn left at the second corner. Again, we don't use the ni particle for at the second corner. We say 角を左に曲がる、okay? So, where are you turning? You use the O particle.And which way are we turning? Left or right? We use the ni particle. And then 曲がると, this to particle doesn't mean and technically. It's the conditional form if, usually be translated like when or if. So 左に曲がると, and then 右側にあります. It's on the right side. 右Right, 右側, right side, にあります. So which place are we talking about? どの場所について話していると思いますか? 学校, 学校, school. So the full conversation could be something like this. すみません。アモ学校に行きたいんですが。アモ学校ですね。この道をまっすぐ行って、二つ目の角を左に曲がると右側にありますよ。すみません。アモ学校に行きたいんですが。アモ学校ですね。この道をまっすぐ行って、二つ目の角を左に曲がると右側にありますよ。Okay, now look at this map. この地図を見てください。And where is the library? The library, we say? 図書館。Right, so if you want to say, where is the library? You can say, 図書館はどこですか? Right? 図書館はどこですか?
And you can say that it's behind the school, right? Do you know how to say behind?
後ろ
So if you want to say behind the cow, you can say 牛の後ろ Okay, anyway, if you want to say A is behind B, you can say A は B の後ろです。Or A は B の後ろにあります。Okay? So how would you say the library is behind the school?
図書館は学校の後ろにあります。
Alright, so if someone asks you where is the library and you have to give directions from the station, then you can use the previous
まっすぐ行って、二つ目の角を左に曲がると、
So you could, for example, say that you have to go straight and turn left at the second corner and you'll see the school and the library is behind the school. Okay, so we all know how to say all those things. So can you try giving me directions? So you can pause the video. Did you pause? 止めた? Anyway, how would you say, go straight?
まっすぐ行って
And if you want to add the word, go straight down this road, on this road, you say,
この道をまっすぐ行って
And then turn left at the second corner.
二つ目の角を左に曲がると
You'll see a school on the right side.
右側に学校が見えます。右側に学校が見えます。
And the library is behind the school.
学校の後ろにあります。
So instead of this, you can also say,Keep going straight and you'll see the library on the left side. So, you could also do
この道をずっとまっすぐ行くと左側に図書館があります。
So, ずっと means forever or for a long time. Like there is slang ずっとも which means BFF, best friends forever.Because ずっと means forever and 友 comes from 友達ずっと Or if, for example, you could say go straight down this road and walk for 10 minutes and you'll see it on the left side. So you could, for example, add the word
10分ぐらい歩く
10分 10 minutes 10分ぐらい approximately 10 minutes about 10 minutes.
歩く walk.
So, you could for example say,
この道をまっすぐ行って、10分ぐらい歩くと、左側にあります。
Can you repeat?
この道をまっすぐ行って、10分ぐらい歩くと、左側にあります。
So, 10分 is 10 minutes, right? And 10分ぐらい歩く is walk for 10 minutes. You don't have to add any particle between 10分 and 歩く. Like, we added ぐらい because we wanted to make it sound like about 10 minutes. But you can also say 10分歩くと he walk for 10 minutes. And if you want to, for example, say it takes 10 minutes on foot,You can say,
歩いて10分かかります。Or, 歩いて10分かかる。
So when you want to say it takes the amount of time, you say time
かかる。
So 1時間かかる。It takes an hour. 5分かかる。It takes 5 minutes. And 歩く means to walk, but 歩いて、if you put 歩く in the te form, it can mean on foot or by walking.So, for example,
歩いて5分ぐらいかかります。 So when you want to say how far is it from here, you can obviously use the adjective 遠い and say どのくらい遠いですか?どのくらい how 遠い far どのくらい遠いですか? How far is it? But you can also ask like ここからどのくらいかかりますか?ここからどのくらいかかりますか? This is another common question. ここ here, ここから from here. どのくらい how long かかりますか? Does it take? And the human said, does it take to get to this place? Then you can say place まで, right? So you could say ここから学校までどのくらいかかりますか?ここから学校までどのくらいかかりますか? And the other person could say, for example, 歩いて10分ぐらいかかります。It takes about 10 minutes on foot. Or バスで5分ぐらいかかります。It takes about 5 minutes by bus. You will also hear 歩くと結構かかりますよ。歩くと、if you walk, 結構 means quite a bit, かかりますよ、it takes. So it takes quite a bit of time if you walk. 歩くと結構かかりますよ。I've heard that phrase a lot. But if something is just right across the corner or it's like really nearby, you can say, すぐそこですよ。すぐそこですよ。It's just there. It's just down the street. It's just...round the corner. そこ means there, like there, usually near you, right? And すぐ means immediately or ASAP, like すぐ来て, come here ASAP. And instead of turning at the corner, you might turn right at the traffic light or intersection, right? So traffic light, we say 信号, 信号.You know, when talking about traffic light, we don't say green light, but we say blue light. I have a lesson on why we say 青, so check it out. But anyway, 信号 is traffic light. So how would you say turn right at the second traffic light? So second. 二つ目の traffic light. 信号And then, which part to go next? 二つ目の信号を Turn right.
右に曲がってください。二つ目の信号を右に曲がってください。
And do you know how to say intersection, crossroads? We say
交差点、交差点。
You might know this word, 交差点, if you live in Tokyo, because there is a famous crossing in Shibuya, right? That one is called
Scramble 交差点.
Scramble is scramble.
Scramble 交差点.
So you could, for example, say
渋谷に行って Scramble 交差点が見たい。渋谷に行ってで、スクランブル交差点が見たい。
I want to go to Shibuya and see the Shibuya crossing. So how would you say, please turn left at the first intersection? So, the first, you can either say,
一つ目の
or you could also say,
最初の
最初 means the beginning. And if you say 最初のIt can also mean the first. Like,
最初のページ,
the first page. We would use the word 最初の, especially if it's the beginning of something. So the reason why we say 最初のページ for the first page is because it's the beginning of the book, right? Whereas 一つ目 doesn't have to be like the beginning of something. It could be the first, but it doesn't have to be at the beginning, right? If you know what I mean.Anyway, you could either say,
一つ目の交差点
or
最初の
交差点。So let's use 一つ目の here. 一つ目の交差点を左に曲がってください。一つ目の交差点を左に曲がってください。Okay, now listen to this dialogue. すみません、この近くに ATM はありますか？そこの交差点を右に曲がると左側にコンビニがあります。ATM はコンビニの中にありますよ。すみません、この近くに ATM はありますか？そこの交差点を右に曲がると左側にコンビニがあります。ATM はコンビニの中にありますよ。Okay, so the question was, この近くに ATM はありますか？ So, この近く is nearby, near this place. You should remember this, この近くに、この近く、but you'll also hear このあたり。And that means around this area, around here. このあたり。And also この辺、この辺。The kanji is the same as あたり, but without any 送り仮名。この辺、このあたり。And you also hear ここら辺、ここら辺。So, この近く and このあたり are both very common. And ここら辺 and この辺 sound slightly more casual. Okay? So, if you're talking to your friends, they might say この辺 or ここら辺. But if you're speaking formally and ask for directions, you might say このあたり or この近く more. Okay? So, この近くに we put the に particle because of the verb ある. There is, right? So you say place に something がある or place に something はある. Okay, so I said ATM はありますか? Is there an ATM? So remember this construction, okay? この近くに something はありますか? Is there da, 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 around here? You can also make この and say 近くに ATM はありますか? And then the answer.そこの交差点を、so, 交差点 intersection, right? And then, そこの basically means the intersection over there. そこの交差点を右に曲がると if you turn right at the intersection there, 左側にコンビニがあります。There is a convenience store on your left, right? 左側にコンビニがあります。And then, ATM はコンビニの中にあります。The ATM is inside the convenience store. ATM はコンビニの中にあります。Alright, now I want you to try giving directions using the same construction. So let's say we are in front of the convenience store and you want to ask, is there cinema nearby? And if you look at this map, you see that the cinema is inside the department store, デパート, right? So I want you to guide the person to the department store first. Then you can say,The cinema is inside the デパート, department store. Okay? So you can say, please turn right at the traffic light. And there is a department store on your left. And the cinema is inside the department store. All right. Pause the video. All right. Are you ready to check if you are correct? Now listen to this dialogue.
すみません。近くに映画館はありますか？そこの信号を右に曲がると、左側にデパートがあります。映画館はデパートの中にあります。
すみません。近くに映画館はありますか？そこの信号を
右に曲がると左側にデパートがあります。映画館はデパートの中にあります。
Alright, so now we know how to say A is inside B. A は B の中にあります。And also we know how to say A is behind B. A は B の後ろにあります。Remember, the library is behind the school.
図書館は学校の後ろにあります。
Right? So now let's look at this map and practice how to say A is in front of B, A is across the road, A is next to this, A is between this. So do you remember where the school is?
学校はどこか覚えていますか?
And if I ask you, where is the bus stop? How would you answer? So first, how would you say bus stop?
バス停、バス停。
So, バス停はどこですか?
And you want to say, it's in front of the Amo 学校,
Amo school. So you can say,
バス停は学校の前です。前です。
Or, if you use the verb ある, then,
バス停は学校の前にあります。
Make sure to put the ni particle if you use the verb ある, あります。
Okay, now we are at the bus stop.
今バス停にいます。And I ask you, where is the post office?
郵便局はどこですか?
So I want you to say, turn right at this corner and you'll see a bank on your left and the post office is next to the bank. Okay? Pause the video and try. So,Bank, we say 銀行 And if you want to say A is next to B, we say
A は B の隣です Or A は B の隣にあります
Okay, now pause the video. Alright, now listen to the dialogue.
郵便局はどこですか?この角を右に曲がると左側に銀行があります。郵便局は銀行の隣にあります。郵便局はどこですか?この角を右に曲がると左側に銀行があります。郵便局は銀行の隣にあります。
Okay, now we're at the post office. 郵便局にいます。And you can see that the flower shop is pretty close, right? So how would you say the flower shop is near the post office? Use the の近くにあります。
花屋は郵便局の近くにあります。
If you say 花屋は郵便局に近いです That's fine, but it's more like the flower shop is close to the post office. So you're just stating the fact that you're telling how close or far it is rather than saying that place is located near the post office. And you see there is a hair salon next to the flower shop. How do you say?The hairdresser's or hair salon is next to the flower shop. Do you know how we say my neighbor Totoro in Japanese? We say,
隣のトトロ.
The theme song is, 隣のトトロ, トトロ. Right? So, 隣 means next door, next to something. Okay? Next! When I say next,I say 次, right? But 次 means the next, the following thing. Whilst when something is next to each other, you say 隣. Like if you want to say, sit next to me, you can say
隣に座って隣に座って
So, the hairdresser's hair salon, we say 美容院美容院 So,
美容院は花屋の
隣にあります。美容院は花屋の隣にあります。
Or you could say that the hair salon is between the cafe and the flower shop, right? So you didn't have to say between.
間、間。
So we say A と B の間、between A and B. So you can say C は A と B の間です。Or C は A と B の間にあります。So how do you say the hair salon is between the cafe and the flower shop? Pause the video.
美容院はカフェと花屋の間にあります。美容院はカフェと花屋の間にあります。
And now you see the pharmacy or the drugstore is across the road, right? So, when you want to say across the road, you say 向かい側、
向かい側。
You can also use the word 反対側、the opposite side.
反対側。
So, if you want to say the pharmacy is across the road, you can say
薬局は向かい側にあります。薬局は道の向かい側にあります。お、薬局は反対側にあります。
So if you are at the school and you have to say where the bus stop is, you can also say
バス停は道の向かい側にあります。お、反対側にあります。
Alright, the last conversation example.
すみません。有名なパン屋があると聞いたんですが、どこにあるか知っていますか？
あ、ピーターパンですね。少し歩きますよ。
そこの角を右に曲がって少し歩くと公園があります。その角を左に曲がって少し歩くと右手にあります。
すみません。有名なパン屋があると聞いたんですが、どこにあるか知っていますか？
あ、ピーターパンですね。少し歩きますよ。そこの角を曲がってまっすぐ行くと公園が見えます。その角を左に曲がって少し歩くと右手にあります。
Alright, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned a lot from this video. And I'll post exercises on Patreon, so check it out if you want. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with everybody. It really makes me happy. Alright, じゃあまたね。バイバイ。